1, Jamaica. With us, our head coach Randy Waldrum and striker Tasha and Louis. We're expecting the captain Maylee Attin-Johnson, as well as Aaron Kinder on their way up.
They
now join us. Alright, so we continue with the usual proceedings. We allow Coach Waldrum and his two players to give us an opening remark to tonight's victory, and then we open the floor to questions. Coach, your reaction to tonight's victory?
Well, I think very excited to get the win, of course. I think you played a great side in Jamaica. I think you saw a little bit tonight the fact that they've been together for most of the summer down in Miami. So it was a very difficult game for us. But I thought, considering we've been together a short time, it wasn't our best performance by any means, but we needed a game like this tonight where we were going to get stretched so we could find out, you know, the areas that we need to work on. But having said that, I couldn't be more proud of the effort, you know, to go through four games and score 21 goals and not give anything up. A lot of credit goes out to these young ladies, and I appreciate it. Now we need your help continuing to support us as we take the next step in the ladder, so to speak, with CONCACAF.
I think going into this game, especially against Jamaica, we knew it would have been a dogfight. And in the past, we'd have come out on the opposite side of end result, you know. And it's really good to see that we scored early, exactly what the coach told us to do, get on them early, and we executed that well. I think the performance, obviously, we need to improve on, but I think for us, moving forward, these are the kind of victories we need to get, you know, because we won't accustom getting this type of victory. And one thing I told my teammates, you know, once our leg gave out, play with our heart, and that's exactly what we did. I'm proud of them, and this win is for a gift for independence, which we're going to do. So.
Tasha, tell us a little bit about the victory.
I felt very proud, of course, of my teammates, and the support that we got tonight was tremendous. You know, players, we went in there with a plan. You know, we didn't execute it well, but we stayed in the game most of the time. And I was glad that we came out to the game, and I'm very, very happy.
Coach, you mentioned that you were stretched tonight. In what areas and what do you see still needs to be done?
Well, we knew they were going to play very direct with the pace they had up top. And I think we maybe respected that pace a little bit too much. I felt our backs played too deep and gave them way too much room in front of our back line to pick up balls and run at us. At times we didn't drop well when there wasn't enough pressure on the ball, and they got in behind us a couple of times. Erin King, I thought, played great in the back. She made two really big saves in the first half, individual efforts, and I think Rhea made one as well. So defensively, we got pulled apart a little bit in the back. So that's clearly an area that we hadn't been stretched in the earlier games, and we needed to see that. You know, I think too that because of that, dropping so deep with the back line, our midfield line dropped too deep, and then we never could pick up a second ball. If we got it cleared, then it dropped to them, and they were on top of us again. So we got to be more efficient with that, you know, and a little bit more disciplined in getting a handle on the game. But those were a couple of areas that I felt we weren't strong in tonight.
We have about a month and a half to be public half. What's the plan
with Tom? Well, I've spoken with Sheldon Phillips a little bit about the plan and moving forward, and President Tim Key. And I think that the plan is we need this 6 weeks desperately to be together as much as we can. That's where I think the local community who supported us so great tonight can help us. We need help funding it. We need all the kind of help we can to generate all the resources that we possibly can to go 6 weeks. You know, there's eight teams in 3.5 spots. I think it's probably the best opportunity in probably the next 10 years of us having the chance to qualify. So it's going to be a really important 6 weeks. And the plan is to give them a few days off. We've been 2 weeks in Houston, and to give them off until after maybe the 5th. The draw is on the 5th. And then we'll pick back up with training at that point, and we'll get through up until the qualifiers.
Can you personally, is it tonight or how will I be working on, you know, that?
With me as the coach moving forward, is that your question?
The
understanding that we had with the federation was that I would take them through the World Cup. So my plan is to be here. I'm very excited to be here. I've loved the time with the players. I can't think of a more deserving group of young lady than this group. It's talented, they're passionate, they've committed, many of them, you know, like these two sitting here, 10 or 12 years of their life to have this one dream come true. And if I can be a small part of helping that, I want to be here. And I really appreciate the fan support tonight. I had so many nice comments from the fans about congratulating me personally on the job we've done, and hope everybody's happy with what they've seen.
Coach, I mean, you're supposed to be able to call upon any personnel at any point in time, but you had some injury concerns going into this match, and even during having to switch around players. You know, what was the, I guess, the thought behind it, and also in terms of calming the players down to help them understand that, yes, it's a final we're playing, but you have to go and execute and play a role.
Yeah, you talk about the changes I've made during the game tonight. Yeah, I think, you know, the game kind of dictated, based on the players' health, the changes that we had to make. You know, I felt like we were losing a little bit in midfield as the game wore on. And I thought by dropping Tasha into midfield, it would give us a little bit more of a ball-handling presence, a calming effect, because she's so good at, with her experience in keeping the ball. And I think about the time we were getting ready to make that change, Mariah was feeling it. You know, she was almost playing right back half the game, chasing so much. So I think I think she was just gassed, so it made perfect sense then to bring on Darnell and to drop Tasha in. So that was one of the moves we made. And then we felt like the same thing as we move forward with it. Patrice was really injured. She felt a little bit of her leg, a strain in her leg. So we had to go in with Taylor Mims on that move. So the moves really that we made were out of necessity, you know, out of players cramping up or getting injured. And that's why this 6 weeks, going back to the question, is so important. You know, in 2 weeks' time, considering we played a team that's been together most of the summer, I'm proud of them. You know, I think there's no way you can get fit in 2 weeks. So we have a lot of work to do in that area. But those moves tonight really came out of that. I think at halftime, we just really talked about trying to settle into our game and keep it a little bit more. But I felt like, too, because we were dropping so deep, I said we don't have to worry at times about playing so attractive. You know, we kept trying to play out of the back and be attractive, but it was we weren't connecting out of the back and it allowed them to get on top of us. And I said, at times, sometimes you have to recognize you just got to play the ball deep in behind and change the real estate a little bit. I thought we could have done a better job at that, but that's one of the things that we talked about as well in the second half.
Is the door still open for more players, or are you satisfied with the bunch that you have, and are you going to be working with this bunch going forward?
Well, I think you're always looking. You know, one of the things I told this group when we got them together in day one is that they're professionals now. You know, it is they have to take that mentality. It's no different than any major European club team or teams we see around the world, whether you're playing for Real or Barcelona. The coach is always looking to make improvements to the team. And there's certainly some players out there, I think, that can help us that aren't in this particular camp right now. So the one thing I want the players to understand is there is going to be competition, you know, and this was a really good group. This out of the group I had in Houston, and to the players that were available, this was the best group for a lot of different reasons right now. Moving forward, I think we'll always be looking for those other players that can come in and help us qualify, and I think these players understand it, that they've got to stay sharp and committed and on top of their game.
Maybe how do you think we did it in the field back in today, especially for the first hour? What could we have done better, if anything?
I think for us, we lost shape. It was our shape a whole lot, and fortunately for us, they didn't take advantage of that. I don't think they went through our middle a whole lot. I think one of the players that we were looking to shut down was number 20, and in the second half, she really got one service long, you know. Every time she got the ball, we'd go back. So in terms of that, we did pretty well. In attack, I think, you know, we didn't connect well, and we didn't follow the ball going forward. You know, a lot of us were pretty much more defensive-minded, especially going up 1-0 second. And, you know, those are things we didn't work on. And, you know, I think that was it.